I'm here at the Royal Northern College of Music, where we're using their fantastic theatre to put on one of our mass inspiration shows. I'm joined by my mathematical friends, Rob Easterway, Kay Stickles, and Hugh Hunt. This is the second video where I'm once again going to challenge one of them to show me the best bit of mathematics they can fit on a single postcard.
Okay, Rob is now doing his part of the show, which means I can go backstage, find Hugh, and do some maths.
I'm now backstage with Hugh, while Rob is out there doing something with the young people, and you were showing them some mechanics. So what are you going to show me?
Riding the Wall of Death, right. Guy Martin wanted to ride around a vertical
wall. This is
wall.
One of the things you showed the students. Yeah, you had a little video from, what channel was it on?
It was on Channel 4.
Channel 4 did a video of Guy Martin, something, he's a motorbike guy.
Yeah.
Riding around a wall of death.
And he wanted to ride at 100 miles an hour. Now, a typical wall of death,
right.
It's about a 4 meter diameter circle, the ones you've seen fairground rides, yeah, okay, at yep. Fairgrounds. And they ride at about 25 miles an hour.
So he came to you and said, I want to do that,
yeah,
100 miles
so,
an hour.
Yeah, I really, I'll be able to do 100 miles an hour. Basically, Guy Martin says I can do it. But what's beautiful is that he does believe in the maths. And so he will say, if I had my time over again, I wouldn't have fallen asleep in maths lessons.
Would
I would have
maths.
Paid attention.
But now
because now I realise it's so important. And I know that it's right. Now, what's interesting is, that if you think about your speed, and you might measure speed in meters per second.
Yep, I do.
And you might measure the radius of a circle.
Yes.
In meters.
Meters, good, yeah.
And the g-force you experience, that's the acceleration you experience. So at the moment, you're standing
right.
Here, you've experienced one
g. A single g.
And g, the g-force, we measure that in meters per second squared.
So normally we have G from gravity straight down, but you're using it in a more general, just acceleration pressing you against something.
So if you felt twice as heavy, four times
two
as
G's.
Heavy,
two four G's. G's,
four G's.
Got
right.
it, got it, got it.
So, but that, we know what the units.
The units are meters per second,
yeah. Okay.
Squared.
Now the only way we can combine these things, if I call this speed, let's call that V, the radius R,
yep.
And we've got G. The only way we can combine these things so that the units cancel out is like this.
How'd you work that out?
Well, because V squared gives me seconds squared, and that's what I need over here.
So you've looked at these units and gone,
ooh.
I don't know what the equation is,
right.
But if this is meters per second squared, the only way I can get those
seconds
units
squared is by squaring
from these. I've got to square that.
And then I've got one too,
I've got
many
one
m's.
Too many m's.
So I've got to divide by r. And this means I've
so
got
you just derived that then from the units?
Yeah.
That's amazing. There could be a coefficient at the front that we don't know
could
about.
Be, yeah, it could be a coefficient. So it could be pi. It could be 7.
Right.
So interesting, for instance, you might take the period of a pendulum.
Right.
Is root L over G.
2 pi.
It's a 2 pi.
2 pi?
Okay.
Yeah.
So
you
how
never
do you
know.
Know?
You never know.
You never know. But never at least know. You know that the period of a pendulum is independent of mass.
Got
because right, so here.
So you know. Some multiple at the front, but it's constant.
Yeah.
It only depends on the velocity squared over the
right.
radius.
Yeah, so now Guy wants to go around a circle at, normally you do 25 miles an hour, he wants to do 100. So this four times faster, 16 times. So assuming the G forces say roughly the same, we have to build a circle which is 16 times bigger.
So you're saying at a normal wall of death, what would this radius be? This is like
about
2 meters.
2 meters.
2 meters, right, right, right.
Yeah.
And how fast do people go when they do that?
25 miles an hour.
25 miles an hour. And you're assuming that's just a kind of a safe level
yeah, well,
of G.
Because people.
Because they would go faster otherwise.
Well, they try to go faster, but they find that they pass
they
out.
They run out of blood
and
in their
yeah,
head.
The blood, yeah, the blood and the. Their eyeballs, the eyes start to distort.
No matter how you end that sentence, it's not a good thing. The moment you say, yeah, and the eyeballs, I'm like, I'm out.
And the bladder.
And the bladder. See all these things, right? So you're assuming that's kind of a by experiment, yeah. upper threshold that's on speed.
And
so we want to go from 25 miles an hour to 100 miles an hour.
Yeah, and so the idea that Guy Martin could just do it on this little wall it's silly
insane.
Because
it's going to have
the g-force will be 16 times
16 times
pass
okay,
so we've got to make the radius 16 times
to compensate
bigger.
Oh, okay.
And how do you do that? Well, that's a big build.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like 32 meters.
It'll cost £1 million to build. It's just too. And
it'd be like 200 meters around.
Yeah, around this way. Yeah.
And like 60 whatever meters.
Yeah, yeah.
Across.
So, and it's
that's doable.
And but you've got to do it indoors because it's really important that it doesn't get wet.
Ah, right.
So
okay.
If it rains, then
and
it's too slippery.
Channel 4 weren't going to fund that.
Well, where are you going to find a place that's indoors? Yeah, Millennium.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Dome
yeah.
or something.
Yeah.
So we found somewhere indoors, a disused hangar, it was a World War II yeah. hangar. But we could only fit a 40-metre wall in there. Right. So that's interesting. 40 metres.
Diameter.
Instead of 4 metres diameter.
Right, okay, so
10 times bigger radius.
Yep.
So the speed can be roughly
square root of 10.
About pi, that's
yeah.
right. So three and a bit times.
Yeah.
And what speed did he manage? 80 miles an hour. It's kind
so
of...
Pretty much. So he pushed
exactly.
it slightly, but not...
So he did... He achieved what we would expect to achieve from the maths. And what I think is great about this is that we can derive this equation, which... You know, kids at school do for their mechanics,
yep.
their A-levels.
Because you were showing these exact equations to the students.
Yeah, but you can derive it just by looking
knowing
at
the units and a little bit of logic.
The units.
That's so good. And what I love is when Guy came to you and said, I got this crazy idea, you probably pretty much did this level of working out.
Yeah, that's it.
And this is it. And that's all you need.
So there what I think that Guy realised was that he, deep down, he is not a particularly special human being. He
right.
has eyeballs and bladders.
And bladders
and
things.
Things
he likes to keep
like
where they
anybody
are.
Else, right? And so he said, yeah, okay, 80 miles an hour, that's it. Well, it's important that Guy looks after his bladder
yep.
and his eyeballs and things. But the bike, we've got to make sure that the tyres don't
okay, so
burst.
The bike is under the same
carburetor.
G-force, you be careful.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, but it's all here, basically. So if anyone does want to do a wall of death on a motorbike, that's all the maths, that's all the working out you've got to do. Just do one postcard's worth of working out. And then get on your motorbike. So that is one postcard's worth of mathematics. If you want to see the other two postcards worth of maths, you can check out the other two videos in the series. And if you are a teacher, we do these maths inspiration shows all around the UK. They're great fun. We have different speakers every time, and we thoroughly enjoy exciting your students with mathematics. And so they go back to the classroom, hopefully more eager to learn. You can check out more information on it at mathsinspiration.com. It'd be great to see you at one of these.